I'm sure this was my first exposure to a vampire. I certainly wasn't scared of this vampire. I didn't know at 6 years old that he was a creature of the night, that he needed human blood to survive. I just thought it was funny. In 1437, Vlad Țepeș Dracul became Prince of Wallachia, one of three Romanian provinces. This, the time of the Crusades, was a very volatile period for Romania. It lay on the threshold of Christian and Muslim empires. Vlad Țepeș was a vicious and bloody ruler. His enemies were spared no mercy and were usually tortured to death by being hanged, squashed, stabbed, beheaded, buried alive, skinned, boiled, nailed, roasted, tarred, burnt, or his personal favorite, impaled on a stake. At one point, as many as 20,000 people were impaled outside the Wallachian palace. It's said that when the Turkish army arrived to attack, they turned back in fear of the 20,000 rotting corpses. For only the devil himself would make a garden of the dead. In 1897, Bram Stoker publishes his novel Dracula, based upon folklore and the life of Vlad Dracul. It becomes one of the top-selling fiction novels of its time and creates the first mass public interest in vampires. In 1899, Sir Heathrow Dobbs of London claims to be a vampire. Over the next 4 years, 143 people throughout Europe claim to either be, have seen, or witness the acts of a vampire. In 1922, Nosferatu, a German silent film based on Stoker's novel, is released. In 1924, German Fritz Harman, the infamous vampire of Dusseldorf, kills his first victim. At the time of his arrest, he was found to be responsible for 79 other deaths. In 1931, Universal Pictures releases Dracula, starring Bela Lugosi. The film becomes enormously popular. That same year, Peter Curtin is executed for murdering as many as 20 people in a vampire killing spree. In 1976, Anne Rice publishes Interview with the Vampire, creating a more sexual image of the vampire. In the following years, The Lost Boys made him hip, Brad Pitt and Tom Cruise made him beautiful, and Gary Oldman made him vulnerable. When I got a call informing me that a man in rural Alabama claimed to be a vampire, I had to find out firsthand. To find out if he could live up to the image that pop culture had created for him. One of blood, sex, and glamour.
The life ain't as fucking glamorous as it's all been meant out to be. Anne Rice, fuck her. She don't know shit about being a fucking vampire. Rotten. Bram Stoker, that guy's full of shit too. There ain't nothing like it. I thought I'd known life when I was back out in the field, out in the war. Bullshit. It sucks, man.
You wired me awake and hit me with a hand of broken nails. You tied my lead and pulled my chain to watch my blood begin to boil. But I'm gonna break my rusty cage and run. I'm gonna break my rusty cage.
That was a little snack there.
And run. Ooh.